This is Every Third Thursday, a chance for us to have some fun in our factory, get creative with board design and materials, just get spontaneous, come up with a theme, and build it.
This Every Third Thursday could possibly be the most epic build to date. We're combining surfing and snowboarding.
This surfboard snowboard reminded me immediately of Dave Downing back in the mid-90s when he paddled into Mount Rose, just surfing, you know, with no bindings. And I wanted to see if we could really push this board more into that collaborative mode of surf and snow, so we need to add more snowboard elements to it. We don't know much about surfboards, so it was important that we work with friends of ours in the surf industry. Mark's good friends with Doc. He loved it, so he helped us dive into the idea. The first concept with this surf snowboard was to build a board inside a board.
We route, and then as we get to here, it'll just disappear, and this will just all blend into the nose of the surfboard. It'll all be one. It's gonna work out perfect.
It is gonna work out perfect.
Basically bevel out the underside of the surfboard so there was about a half inch of our powder board shape, so that if we were on cat tracks or we were on something where we needed a little control while we're snowboarding, you would have that little bit of leverage to ride on the base.
This is where mad skills come in.
Yeah, this is where mad skill comes into play. Well, it looks pretty cool. Look at that thing. Oh my God. It's a snowboard. It's a surfboard. No, it's a snowboard. No, it's a surfboard.
It's now time to put the inserts in. So we actually take a piece of our snowboard core and put it inside the surfboard so that the bindings can be mounted.
We'll rat out the foam and this gets flush with the deck. So this is inserted in the deck. We're gonna glass over it and do the whole deck on the top in carbon fiber.
So that we don't rip out, we lay carbon over the top, and Doc was pretty sure of it, knowing that big wave surfers use carbon to keep their inserts in. The board then goes over to future fins and gets fin boxes dropped in so we can try multiple combinations in the water and on snow.
This is gonna be the first time I've ever put something in like this, so we're gonna figure it out as we go, I guess.
Nice. Let the fins begin. From there, it goes back to docks, gets fiberglassed before it comes to our factory where we put the base on it. And that's the final touch. Like, we need the centered base for the mountain so that it's durable, it's fast.
Vacuum bag.
We bust out the vacuum bag for the base on this surfboard because we can't use our high pressure presses. They'll just crush the foam. So the vacuum bag basically just sucks all the air out of the bag and makes a nice seal. It takes about 3 hours. We have a finished board and it's time to surf, and we are not surfers. So we reach out to some friends and we get the ultimate person to ride the surfboard. Rob Machado. We drove down to Encinitas where Rob lives. It's a little bit of a hot spot for people, and a lot of people started coming into the parking lot. They'd heard we were down there with an interesting board, and then Rob just like, let me see what you got.
I think you're gonna dig it.
Nobody's ridden it yet?
No.
Really?
Yeah. You ready to check it out?
Can I look at it?
Yes. Wow. It's got a tail.
Is that the tail?
Yeah.
I'm excited. I love the tail already. Wow. Look at that thing. Dude, are you kidding?
With a snowboard base. So I can
ride it. It's got a snowboard in it.
Is it gonna work?
Yeah, it'll work for sure.
I love it.
Gets it all ready, waxes it up, and then paddles out, and that's when we just get excited. Like,
it's in the water, it's floating. We're about to watch the first snowboard you can surf go down a wave. Yeah, it's up!
As soon as he dropped in first wave, it was like there was no issue with it at all. He was just instantly like cruising around down the wave, a little cut back, a little cheater five.
That was amazing!
The look on his face was like, yep, surfboard. But we just put so many weird things into that board and he just treated it like any normal surfboard.
I like the real low rocker. When you get on those like open faces, I could feel like it really had like a nice, the weight felt good, like it carved really good.
Board worked.
Yeah, man.
We got some waves.
It was fun.
You made it happen.
I'm psyched. I can't wait to see you on some powder, just like doing the same thing. Are you kidding? Like, I want to see some footage.
Awesome. Well, yeah. I can't thank you enough for doing it.
Yeah, man. Thank you. Awesome. That was fun.
From the beach to the mountains. Can't believe I'm actually throwing this board into a surf bag. I'm gonna take it up to Baldface and shred it.
We knew it was our turn, and it was pretty exciting to think about what we could make that thing do. And especially after watching Rob surf it, there was a lot of anticipation to go out and really make that thing work.
We're at Baldface Lodge in Nelson, BC. We're in the Southern Selkirks. We're here at 6,750 feet. We're up here snowboarding and skiing on 32,000 acres.
I pull out the surfboard for Jeff Pincero and Curtis Sizek, and it is definitely the fish out of water element.
This is gonna be so fucking awesome.
Let's try it out. Let's go.
All right.
The excitement level was a 10. It just becomes one of those moments where you're just so antsy to like see if it's even gonna turn. We drop in for the first time.
Take one.
I just remember thinking, this thing is hauling ass. Like this, the base on it just took off. Had no fins, if it tracked any certain way, then you would kind of have to almost hop your back foot to get into the next heel side or the toe side. But with the stabilizing center fin, you felt better at high speeds. The center fin really stabilized the board. Traversing actually ended up being really fun because it was like going down the line. I just had the longest left I've ever surfed. Gives you a whole new way of looking at the mountain. We picked Curtis Sizek to go with us. Curtis is a great choice because he's one of the younger pros that has really adapted to the backcountry. And we knew if we brought him out to Baldface and we gave him a unique board like this one, he would be able to put it to good use.
Thanks to Baldface for hooking it up. This was an incredible week.
Yeah.
I can't wait to come back.
Baldface, best place ever.
Should we put a leash attachment in it?
No.
The leash just seemed like something we just didn't need. Like surfers don't use it all the time, especially good ones. And we definitely didn't need it. You know, try a no-board it once and the thing takes off and hits a group of trees so hard. But we were the ones that needed the leash.
What happened there?
Hit the reef.
Try it. See what I got.